Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's your girl HBCU Bay, and if you're new to my channel, my name is Marissa, and thank you so much for clicking on this video. So, as you guys can tell by the title of this video, today I'm going to be sharing with you guys a virtual tour of FAMU's campus. Now, before we hop right into this video, I would like to mention that this is not the whole campus. I actually screen recorded this virtual tour that is also found on www.famu.edu. So you guys, if there's something that I didn't show that you guys would still like to see, you guys can check out the virtual tour and see it there. I don't want this intro to be super long, so I'm gonna go ahead and jump right into the video. So located in Tallahassee, Florida, on the highest of seven hills, Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University was founded October 3rd, 1887, with just 15 students and two professors. Straight ahead, you guys will see that this is Lee Hall Auditorium. This area is most commonly known as the Quad. And in the center, you guys will see the Eternal Flame. This statue commemorates FAMU as the 1997-1998 College of the Year. Right behind that is Coleman Library, and to the left of it is the Commons. We will come back to those locations in just a few. So, inside of Lee Hall Auditorium, this is the stage area along with the seating. As you guys can see, it's much larger in person, of course. Now as we head to Coleman Library, you will see these fountains that are very, very cute. You'll see many people take pictures by these pretty often. And it's right across from Lee Hall, so they're not too far. Nothing on here is really to scale, but it's to scale for the most part. Like, you can get a good idea of distance and location, but like I said, it's not true to scale for real. Here is one of the floors inside Coleman. Now, Coleman is different. You may hear people refer to Coleman as Club Coleman because typically the second floor is never really quiet. The third floor, if you want to study in a very quiet space, is quiet. And the fourth floor, it varies. Like, it depends on which area you're in. Another thing I really like about Coleman is that there's a Starbucks on the second floor as well. You might be wondering why I'm referring to Coleman as the second floor, because as soon as when you walk up the stairs of Coleman, you're on the second floor. So yeah. And so as we pass Lee Hall, we are now heading all the way to the School of Allied Health. Now, just giving you guys a view, it's right by Lee Hall, which is right there. And then you just walk down this road right here. And then you're here. The School of Allied Health is one of the three health professional schools at FAMU. The school is divided into five divisions: healthcare management, physical therapy, cardiopulmonary science, I probably didn't say that right, and a couple of other words I probably can't pronounce. But this, if this is the major for you, that's the building for you. Now we're heading to Jones Hall. And just looking around, it's pretty close to Lee Hall as well. And I believe it's right across from the School of Allied Health. This virtual tour on FAMU's website gives kind of different angles of the buildings, but there's many different ways to enter most of these buildings, but for some odd reason, they show the weirdest way to enter these buildings. However, Jones Hall is the main building for the College of Science and Technology. And here is a biochemistry lab that they have. Never actually been inside of Jones Hall, but pretty interesting. So yeah, I don't think this is the most common way to enter, but I'm not sure. But here's one of the entrances. Now we are heading to College of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences. And coming back around, this award-winning program has been recognized as one of the nation's top 12 pharmacy programs. Here's another view of the building, I'm sure from a different angle. And here is what looks like a classroom, or it could be a computer lab. Not sure, I've never been in here. But yeah. So now, we're heading to the Black Archives and Research Center. You're gonna head down. And like I said, for some reason on this virtual tour, it takes you through funky different directions, and for some reason it took us the back way through the Black Archives. So actually right now we're in the front. As I go around the map, I don't know if you can see, but you can slightly see a little building behind those trees, and that's Tucker Hall. And then to the left is Jones Hall. The Black Archives and Research Center was first built as Carnegie Library, which was officially opened to the public in 1908. This library was also the campus's first brick veneer building. In 1976, Carnegie Library became the founding home of the Black Archives Research Center and Museum. If you guys ever have free time or just, you know, ever need something to do, I would say stop by and visit the Black Archives. It is full of so much interesting history. You will literally learn and find different information about every building on this campus, because most information is found in the Black Archives about all the buildings around FAMU's campus. But it's very nice inside. Very nice. I recommend you take a trip. Don't even have to be there long. Just take a trip and visit. So now we're heading to Tucker Hall, which is fairly close to the Black Archives. Tucker Hall is the home of the university's College of Social Science, Arts, and Humanities, and is also the prime spot for FAMU's very own productions held by the Essential Theater. So this is the main entrance. This is what it looks like in the main entrance. And also, familiarize yourself with Tucker, because you may or may not have like one or two classes in this building. I know I did my freshman year. So here is the theater dressing room. And I definitely would say whenever FAMU has a show, I definitely would say make sure you guys go check it out. As we walk down, that's Gore to your right. In front is the School of Journalism and Graphic Communications. I believe this is the main entrance that you guys are looking through right now. Right up in there is the main entrance. And then you guys will see the inside. Cute little station, very high-tech technology. But the School of Journalism and Graphic Communications, most commonly known as J School, is the university's prime location for all things media. This award-winning program houses a state-of-the-art virtual studio, satellite and traditional radio stations, a television station, a newspaper station, and even their very own student-run magazines. Another thing that I find that's cool about J School is that a lot of my friends that are in J School always write these amazing articles about other students on campus and like things that they're doing. And I just think that's really interesting and cool to read, because it's like they're writing their own news articles and stuff. I think that's pretty cool. But right across from J School is SBI, the School of Business and Industry. As we walk up, you guys can also see not too far is FAMU Village, and right up in there is Pettifoot Complex. However, it will not be available. It will not be an available dorm to live in no longer. And then J School's right across the street. So as you guys walk up into SBI, you will notice that on your left is the SBI Big Board. This is a list of all the school's career partners. It's very cool to see on the wall. I really like it, it's cute. A lot of SBI grads will take their graduation pictures right in front of it. It's really nice. So the School of Business and Industry, which is commonly known as SBI, under the leadership of our founding dean, Dr. Sybil C. Mobley, SBI was established in 1974. With over 10 different majors and programs, SBI is the home to its very own Bloomberg Lab. Now, I will say, when I first walked inside, I felt like I was in The Maze Runner. I don't know if y'all seen that movie, but it's built very different. It can get confusing. All the buildings are referred, you know, north, south, east, west. Another pointer I will give you guys is that one thing about SBI, I don't know why this is. No one has ever told me. I've just never seen anybody do it. But you never, ever, ever cut the SBI grass. Like, you never walk on that grass. You're not supposed to. Like, just don't walk on that grass. Please don't be that person that's caught walking on that grass. You just don't. You take the sidewalk, and there's a sidewalk on both sides. So it's not like there's only one sidewalk to walk on. There's a sidewalk on both sides. But as we continue to go down the street, you will see the Welcome Center right there, like a little Welcome Student Center. And then now we are heading into what is known as the Bottom Calf. So the Bottom Calf also has the Student Mailroom. This room is for all things mail. If you get any packages, it'll be here. If you need to send a package, this is where you go. If you need resume paper, this is where you go. If you need to print something in fancy color, this is where you go. You can get a lot of things done in the mailroom. And then bottom calf. And then up those stairs is the top calf. But as we continue, here's some pictures. Bottom calf. Bottom calf has a better variety. However, the difference between bottom calf is you either have to use your own coins or your flex, which is still your own coins, but it's like flex bucks. So like, say for you put 500 flex bucks on your school ID, you have 500 flex. So yeah, one thing I will say about flex is it can go fast. For me, flex goes fast. But bottom calf is lit. They have Wingstop, they have a little pizza place, tropical smoothie, that's where all my flex goes because I love their smoothies. They have a chopping block, which is like a salad bar. What else? And there's a little stand to the side that has like, used to have sushi, I don't know if they do anymore, but there's like ice cream, boiled peanuts, it's real cute. And then here's the Rattler Card office. This is where I'm sure you guys will still get your Rattler Card from, unless they have a new procedure. But if you ever lose your Rattler Card, go there. You need a new Rattler Card, go there. That's all your Rattler Card business in there. And here is our lovely, lovely bookstore. Yay! I have probably bought like one t-shirt from the bookstore because it's really and I make my own paraphernalia for significantly affordable prices for college students, for my FAMU Rattlers out there. So if you guys are interested in purchasing, I will put my little Instagram right here so you guys can take a scroll and see if there's something that catches your eye. And I would love for you guys to check it out and holla at me. But yeah, the bookstore is very lovely though. They have snacks, candy, cute umbrellas, FAMU, everything is up in there. But like I said, it's expensive. Now we're heading on to FAMU Village, which they just changed back to Pocklehorn. Village Pocklehorn. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, and I really hope I am. Pocklehorn Village was built in honor of James R. Pocklehorn. He was a former rattler who joined the U.S. Army after his junior year at FAMU and became a lieutenant. After graduating from Tuskegee Army Airfield in 1944, he became a flight leader of a fighter squadron. On a mission in Italy, his airplane was shot down. He received a Purple Heart for his service to his country. A historical marker was put in place in 2018 to commemorate him, which sits in the middle of the FAMU Village Breezeway. Village is the only dorm on campus for freshmen and sophomores, that you have your own bedroom and your own bathroom, but like with one person. So it's like a Jack and Jill's. Now on the virtual tour, they didn't really show the brooms. However, I have a video already on my YouTube channel that you guys can check out if you would like to get a better look into what Village looks like on the inside and how different people decorated their bedrooms. I'll leave it right here somewhere, and then you guys can check that out. And I'll also leave a link in the description box so you guys can go look at that. But yes, Village is amazing. I loved it. Now we're heading to Bragg Memorial Stadium. Built in 1957, Bragg Memorial Stadium is the home to Florida A&M football. This stadium was named in memory of two of the school's earliest figures in the athletic program, known as the First Family of Rattler Football. So Bragg seats 25,500 people. Don't be that person that doesn't go to a football game because you'll be missing out. Now we are heading to the Alford Lawson Multi-Purpose Center, most commonly known as Al Lawson. Don't ever try and tell somebody that you're about to go to the Alford Lawson Multi-Purpose Center, because they're gonna look at you like, what the heck are you talking about, Al Lawson? Just say Al Lawson, I promise. This state-of-the-art facility is most commonly known for hosting convocations, basketball and volleyball games, homecoming concerts, career fairs, and commencement ceremonies. I love the way Al Lawson looks on the inside. It's so nice. But now we are heading to the rec. The rec is real cool. It's real far from everything. Like, it's a little walk, I'm not gonna lie. But it's really nice inside. It's really nice. Like, here's the lobby. And when you check into the rec, make sure you always have your rattler card, because they will not let you in. You need to sign in with your rattler card. And then I think you have to bring a towel as well. Make you bring like a little mini towel just because, you know, sanitary purposes. So like after you get off the machine, make sure you wipe it down. It's real cute in here. They have rock climbing as well. I've never been rock climbing, but I don't even know if they still let people rock climb that wall. But it's cool. But in the rec, they have so many workout machines. Like, they have anything, you name it, they really do. Everything is up in here, and it's two-story. They also have a nice dance studio with very cute mirrors. Oftentimes, little classes and stuff will be held, hosted in here. I remember I went to this one class. I don't remember it. But now we are heading to the School of Architecture and Engineering Technology. It's right up, like right on the street. And this building is by far probably one of the most interesting buildings to go in on FAMU's campus, because it's just so cool on the inside. Like, it's not like any other building. Although I haven't been around the whole building, I've only been in like this area, but it's really cool. This school is organized in two divisions, a division of architecture and a division of engineering technology. So here is the upper level of the building. And then just here's an example of some projects, I believe. That's just in the area. It's really cool. And just down the street, walking a little bit down, you will be on the set. There's multiple buildings, am a lot around this area, the Grand Ballroom's here as well. There's another dining facility called PDR, which is the Presidential Dining Room. That's also here on the set. So yeah, there's a lot of other stuff here. And one thing that I love about this set, you've probably already seen videos about it, is Set Fridays, where it's basically like a big old party in the middle of the day on Friday. It's just a great time. The set is just a vibe on Fridays. And now we're heading over, that's an example of one of the shops I was talking about. But here's the Commons. I love the Commons so much, mainly because Chick-fil-A is inside of here. But yes, I love me some Chick-fil-A, even though Chick-fil-A do be taking all my flex. This is where most of my flex go. But yeah, also the Professional Development and Career Center is in the Commons. And it's a chill place. Like, it's real cool up in here. It's always a vibe in the Commons. Like, no matter what time of the day, someone is up here in this lobby chatting it up, or in this line, because the lines stay long. But yeah, the Commons is always a vibe. And there's also, you also might end up having classes in the Commons. There's actual classrooms like in the back area, which is pretty neat. Like, as soon as you get out of class, your friends might be up in there, and then you just chill, have lunch, have dinner, whatever. So that wraps up my virtual FAMU tour. Like I said, this was not the whole campus. Not everything was shown in my video, and then not everything is on FAMU's website. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it informative. This was just a cute way to give those students that may have not been able to visit FAMU's campus in person to still have a fun and interactive tour, although it's, like I said, not in person. But if you want to see more, let me know. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next time.